This is part 23 of Azure tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to deploy ASP.NET Web Application with SQL Server Database and Entity Framework as the Data Access Framework to Azure. In part 21 of this video series, we discussed how to deploy ASP.NET Web Application that does not use a database to Azure. This is a one-step process. Using Visual Studio Publish feature, we create an app service and app service plan in Azure, and then hit the publish button to have our code deployed in Azure. With just a few clicks, in just a few minutes, we have our app up and running in Azure. In part 22 of this video series, we discussed how to deploy ASP.NET Web Application that uses SQL Server Database and Edio.NET as the data access framework. This is a three-step process. First, we deploy the web application itself. Second, we create SQL Server and the database. Finally, create the database objects like tables, views, stored procedures, etc., and then seed the database tables with initial application data. In this video, we'll discuss how to deploy ASP.NET Web Application with SQL Server Database and Entity Framework as the Data Access Framework to Azure. If you're new to Entity Framework, please check out our Entity Framework tutorial. I'll include the link in the description of this video. Now, it is this application that we want to deploy to Azure. It retrieves inspirational quotes from a SQL Server Database and displays them on this web page. Notice the URL. It says localhost. So at the moment, this web application is running on my local machine. We want to deploy it to Azure. Now, let's take a look at the project setup. First, web.config file. Notice here we have the database connection string. As you can see from the connection string, at the moment in my project, I'm using SQL Server LocalDB. If you want, you can use a full-blown SQL Server. The process is still the same. Next, we have the quote class. This is a very simple class with just two properties, ID and quote text. In this application, we are using Entity Framework Code First approach. And here is the corresponding DB context class. And notice the name of the class, quote DB context. It has the same name as the database connection string in web.config. And this is important. And at the moment, our application needs only one database table. So within the quote DB context class, we only have one DB set property, DB set of quote. Next, we have the quote repository class. As you can see, this class has got just one method, getQuotes, that returns the list of quote objects. And all it's doing is creating an instance of quote DB context class, retrieving the list of quotes and returning them. And then it is the default.aspx page that is responsible for displaying the list of quotes. And for that, we have a repeater here with item template and alternating item template. And as you can see, both the templates bind to the quote text property of our quote class. And then in the code behind file, in the page load event, we create an instance of quote repository, call the getQuotes method, retrieve the list of quotes, set that as the data source and call the data bind method. Next, we have quote DB context seeder class. This class is important because it is this class that seeds our database tables with initial application data. When we run this application for the first time, we will not have quotes DB database table because we are using Entity Framework Code First approach. So when we run this application for the first time, it creates quotes database table and populates it with our initial data. As you can see from the web page, when we run this app, we see these five quotes, and these quotes are coming from the quotes database table, and it is this seed method that seeds the respective table with initial data. As you can see, we are creating five quotes here and then adding each of the quote objects to quote DB context class and then calling seed method on the base class. Now, when the application starts, we want to call this database context seeder class. So within application start event of global.asax, we are calling quote DB context seeder class using database.setInitializer method. Now, on my local machine, I have already ran this application. So notice both the database quotes DB and the quotes table itself are created, and this table is also populated with the initial C data. Now let's delete this database. There we go, our database is gone. Now let's run our application again. Entity framework code first approach detects we don't have the database anymore, so it's going to do three things. First, it creates the database itself. Next, the database table, and also seeds it with our initial five codes. So in just a few seconds, we should see the codes displayed again. There we go. We see the five codes as expected. Now let's go back to SQL Server Management Studio and then refresh this databases folder. We see our codes DB database, and if we expand this and go to tables, we also see the codes database table. So this is the application that we want to deploy to Azure. I will make this project source code available as a download. I'll include the download link in the description of this video. At the moment, we are in the Azure portal and looking at our codes resource group. And notice within this resource group, we have an app service and app service plan. If you remember, we created both of these from Visual Studio Publish window in part 21 of this video series. And it is this app service that we are going to deploy our application to. Now, in the interest of time, I'm not going to repeat those steps since we have already covered them in part 21. And for this video, they're exactly the same. And if you notice, within this resource group, we don't have our SQL Server database. So let's see how to do that from within Visual Studio. First, get to the Publish window. For that, right-click on the project name in Solution Explorer and select this option, Publish. We want to add a database dependency, so click the Add button and then select Azure SQL Database and then click Next. We don't have any database in Azure yet, so we want to create a new database. For that, click this plus sign. Let's name the database Codes DB, and we don't have a database server in Azure. First, we need to create a database server. For that, click on this new link. Provide a name for the database server, a location, and then an administrator username, password, and then confirm the password. Click OK, and then create. There we go. Both our database server and the database are created. Click Next. Provide a name for the database connection string. We can actually select it from the drop-down list right here. Notice the name. It has got the same name as our DB context class, and this is important. So let's select this and then provide a username and password and then click Next and Finish. Let's close this wizard. All that is left to do now is publish our code to Azure. For that, click on this Publish button. In a few seconds, we should see the five codes displayed. There we go. Take a look at the URL. Our app is up and running in Azure. So the important point to keep in mind is with Entity Framework, we do not have to manually create database tables and seed them with initial data. This is done for us automatically by the Entity Framework DB Context Seeder class. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.